This video is brought to you by Card Kingdom, and while supplies last, if you mention Saffron Olive in your order notes, we'll hook you up with a free Saffron Olive sticker with any Card Kingdom order. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. So, as you know, Monday means it's Modern Monday here in Instant Deck Tech Land, and we have a sweet and fairly budget-friendly list to look at today. This is Rally the Zombies, halfway Zombie Tribal, halfway a Rally the Ancestor deck, and this one comes to us from As Smickler, something like that, who took it to a 5-0 finish in a Modern League on Magic Online. So congrats to Is Mickler on a very sweet deck. And a quick reminder before we break down Rally the Zombies for Modern. If you enjoy this deck and you want to see it main to videos, take a minute, click the like button, the subscribe button, leave a comment, anything you can do to support your deck, because whichever deck is most popular gets a shot at being made into videos next week. So Rally the Zombies, it's kind of this weird deck. It is a Rally the Ancestor deck, but it's also a zombie deck. It's got some weird synergies thrown in. So kind of key card number one, Stitcher Supplier. Just a zombie, comes into play, mills for three, dies, mills for three more. So this is one of our ways to stack the graveyard. And one of the unique things about this deck is we're not overloaded on ways to fill up our graveyard. It's not like we're turboing our graveyard full. Stitcher Supplier is really the only card in our deck that directly just dumps cards into our graveyard. However, it can dump six cards all by itself because we can sacrifice it to Carrion Feeder, which is our main sacrifice outlet. And Carrion Feeder, very, very powerful, allows us to not only sack creatures without paying any mana, but grows into a really big threat on its own because it gets a +1/+1 counter whenever we sacrifice something. So if we throw, let's say, Gravecrawler into the mix, we're sort of building this weird zombie machine where Gravecrawler, we can cast from our graveyard for just a single mana, also just a fine threat on its own. So maybe we mill it over with Stitcher Supplier, maybe we draw it naturally. But if we don't have anything better to do for each mana we have, we can just keep casting Gravecrawler, sacrificing it to Carrion Feeder in between, growing our Carrion Feeder really, really big. And if we throw some other pieces into the puzzle, like let's say Undead Augur, for example, this also turns into an absurd source of card advantage because every time that our Gravecrawler is being sacrificed to our Carrion Feeder, we're going to trigger Undead Augur to draw a card and lose a life. So we're churning through our deck, finding more zombies, finding a Rally the Ancestors. Crypt Breaker is kind of our backup card advantage engine. Doesn't work as specifically with our combo as Undead Augur, which is just a great payoff for sacrificing things to our Carrion Feeder. But still, it's only one mana, it's a zombie, it works with our plan. We can tap zombies to draw cards and then sacrifice them afterwards to our Carrion Feeder to draw more cards and rally them back from the graveyard. Then, when it comes to closing out the game, we're kind of using that same loop with Carrion Feeder, Gravecrawler, but with Wayward Servant and Cruel Celebrant replacing some of our other pieces. So Wayward Servant, zombie comes into play, we get to drain for one. Opponent loses one, we gain one. Cruel Celebrant kind of does the reverse. When one of our creatures dies, we get to drain for one. So let's say we have Carrion Feeder, we have a Gravecrawler somewhere, we got a Wayward Servant and a Cruel Celebrant, we can sacrifice Gravecrawler, which will trigger our Cruel Celebrant. Then we can recast the Gravecrawler, which will trigger our Wayward Servant. Then we can do it again. So basically for every one mana, if we have this set up, we're draining for two, draining for two, draining for two. If we have Undead Augur, we're also drawing cards, churning through our deck, finding more pieces. And then the big bad payoff that just closes out the game is Rally the Ancestors. So if we need to kill our opponent all at once, since all of our cards are two mana or less, what we do is cast Rally for four, and that reanimates everything in our graveyard. So we can sacrifice our entire board to Carrion Feeder, get a bunch of triggers from our Undead Augur to draw cards, from our Cruel Celebrants, from our Wayward Servant to drain our opponent, and then after that we rally, get everything back. That's going to be a huge board full of Wayward Servant triggers. It's going to give us a ton of creatures we can sacrifice again to draw cards, to drain our opponent out of the game. So that's kind of our big finish. Otherwise, Tide Hollow Scholar, basically just our Thoughtseize zombie, comes down, strips something from our opponent's hand as long as it stays on the battlefield. Then we have a little bit of removal. Mostly we're focused on our own plan of draining our opponent out of the game, getting in zombie damage, but Fatal Push, Path to Exile, a little bit of removal for our opponent's creatures. Mana base, one of the reasons the deck is pretty cheap, like $250 or so, is we're not playing any fetch lands. Instead, we get a bunch of Orzhov dual lands, Godless Shrine, Concealed Courtyard, Isolated Chapel, Silent Clearing, can cash that in to draw a card if we run out of action, and some swamps. As far as the sideboard, this is where we can kind of go into zombie tribal more, we have Lord of the Accursed, which is just a 3-mana zombie lord, can even menace up all of our zombies. So if our graveyard's going to be shut down, or we're afraid it's going to be shut down, we can even sideboard out our Rally the Ancestors, bring in Lord of the Accursed, and just go on this weird zombie beatdown plan where we're chipping in for damage with our random zombies, eventually draining our opponent out of the game, getting in big attacks with our lord, pumping everything. Otherwise, Duress to strip apart our opponent's hand against combo and control, Fatal Push for removal against aggro, Fragmentize for artifacts and enchantments, Nile Spell Bomb for graveyard, Stamping Sphere for combo, Stony Silence for hardened scales and Tron and other artifact decks like Urza, and that is Rally the Zombies for Boddard. And that's been our instant deck for today. So thank you so much for watching. I hope y'all enjoyed it, and I will talk to you soon.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.